completes it to Hardman. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And this is incomplete. Oh, he had 6 points right in his hands, but could not hang on.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. Touchdown! Mecole Hardman, as the first half is winding down. And the Chiefs have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now you see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second.
The Chiefs going to go back on offense one final time in this first half.
He's going to run it here up the middle. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. So we've come upon halftime here in KC with the Chiefs on top. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. More from you two in a minute. But first, let's take a spin around the NFL and see what's
past the halfway. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number 3. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going, so what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys would go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to. How did each play work? Okay, what do we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A gain there of 30 big ones.
It doesn't look like this defense found the magic elixir at halftime. This offense was rolling in the first half, and that's continued here in the third quarter. Another big play right there.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. 95 yards rushing forward to the ballgame now on 14 carries. He had a really solid first half running the football and picking up where he left off here in the third quarter.
How about the yardage he's piling up right now? This feels like a full game, not just the series that we're watching right now. I know people are screaming, where are the adjustments from halftime on the defensive side of the ball? Sometimes they're just not there. Sometimes you just got to find a way to tackle someone.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Throwing now is Mahomes. The tight end Kelsey has it over the middle. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark it down at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Great mix of play calling so far. 3 runs, 3 passes. All 3 passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. Down at the 2. Broke through first contact, but ultimately stopped shy of the goal line. From the 2 now, second and goal. They'll try again. And good work there defensively as they're able to keep him out of the end zone. Third and goal now, mere inches from Pater. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal.
It's kind of an interesting decision. One score game, third quarter. What do you do?
Yeah, I'm willing to go out on the limb on this one and go for it. Here's
a look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's up over 100 yards.
Yellow.
They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down. What makes a draw play like that successful?
Well, we did see where he made the first wave miss, and that was a big part of it. But a lot of it is just being actors back there, making the defense think it's going to be a pass.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. Shaquille Griffin in on the stop defensively. And here's a handoff out of the gun. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed.
And out come the Chiefs now. They no longer have the lead after that last touchdown, all tied up in the fourth quarter. And a chance for this offense to mount a potential game-winning drive right here. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and 4.
Hey, Ripley, Ripley.
Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Now, hang on here a second. Looks like a Jaguar in some obvious discomfort from that last play. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. Go to the ground attack. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. 147 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 47. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. That good for 22 on a first down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a score to break this tie. On second down, they'll run it here. And able to get him inside the 5 here, just inside the 5 to about the 4. This will be the 8th play of the drive here, 3rd and 4. They'll try and run this one right up the gun.
And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A great effort there.
His 16th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie. And
here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in quarter number four. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. We'll likely put an end to this thing. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground.
And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Victory in the cards now for the Chiefs as they take a knee here. As they move to 6-3 on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the LA Chargers. Meanwhile, for Jacksonville, it was a game they really needed as they drop back to 4-6. And they'll get a late bye next week, which might be coming at the right time. And they'll be back in action in week 12.